Guys, Coach Bricks here. Hey, I hope you are well. Hope everything's going great for you. For all you athletes and parents out there, you know, you got to ask certain questions when you're getting trained, when you're looking for a trainer, when you're looking for what I like to more or less call a coach. If you're going to a trainer, that's something totally different. But when you're looking for a coach, this could be a sports coach or performance coach, whatever. You got to ask, what kind of knowledge do they bring? Are they continually keeping up with their ever-changing science that comes into it? You know, a lot of trainers out there will show you the latest, coolest exercise, per se. That doesn't mean that exercise is correct. Listen, a lot of stuff that people do and throw up on YouTube is not correct. If you really want to hurt yourself and do stupid things like that, that's great. Go follow a lot of those things. Yeah, they look cool, but they're not getting the job done. They're not improving your performance. Actually, what they're probably doing is they're going to probably hinder your performance. And that's what a lot of trainers do, because they don't want to increase their knowledge. You know, I'm very fortunate that I go and speak at a lot of conferences. Okay, and I talk to very intelligent guys that speak at the same conferences as I do. And, you know, you might have 200-300 people there, maybe 400-500. There's a lot of trainers, so-called trainers out there, that don't do any of that stuff. They don't go out, they don't get the knowledge, they don't go hear other smart, intelligent coaches out there, you know, talking about certain things, getting new ideas and stuff. They don't do those things. Why? Because they think they know it all. It's an ego problem. Right? They think they know it all. And then you buy into the crap that they show. Oh, look at this awesome drill that this kid's doing. That's not an awesome drill. That's an awesome drill to get hurt. It's not an awesome drill. So you got to ask your coach or the trainer that you're working with, how are they improving their knowledge every day so they can improve your performance? Because like I said, it changes all the time. I go and visit other strength coaches, other performance coaches, so I can keep up on what they're doing. How can I add something that they're doing into my routine? I'm always constantly changing. I'm always constantly trying to find better information, more information to help my athletes excel. And a lot of coaches, the majority of them, and trainers do not do that. They live in the same world, and they get their certifications and their exercises off YouTube. All right? That's not going to get the job done. So if that's how your trainer's doing it, you better start thinking differently about your trainer. And also, if they just have a cookie-cutter program, all right, where it's the same thing all the time, all right, they might change an exercise up here and there, but it's pretty much the same, start thinking about that as well. All right? These trainers, so-called trainers and coaches out there, that aren't there for you, they're there for that almighty dollar. You gotta start asking yourself questions. Why am I going to them? Why am I wasting my time and my money? All right? Anybody can sit there and yell their head off. If that's what you're looking for, hell, what I would do is hire an old Army, Navy, Marine, Air Force vet and have them just scream at your son or daughter all day long that they're not going hard. That's not hard to do. Hard is taking an athlete from the beginning and improving their performance the correct way. Okay, now show them the latest, coolest YouTube video, and we're going to try that exercise now when they're not ready for it. But that's what a lot of trainers do. And I see it, and I see it posted, and it disturbs me. It needs to be called out. All right? You got questions, let me know. This is Coach Bricks. Stay strong, stay blessed. Remember, greatness never rests.